Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we'll cover the basic dataset commands. This is the agenda. In this, we will learn how to add a new member, how to edit a member, how to insert a line, then line numbers, reset and column commands. So first of all, adding a new member is similar to adding a file inside a folder in Windows. Suppose you want to add a new file in a folder, then you right click and you add a new text file. Similarly, in mainframes, you can add new members in PDS. For that, you need to type E in front of PDS. Then in the brackets, you need to mention the name of a new member. Then the next is editing a dataset. So the keyword is E. For PS and PDS members, we use E command to open a member in edit mode. Simply type E in front of it and press enter. It will open the member in edit mode. The next is line numbers. Line numbers come on the left hand side of a PS or a PDS members and they are automatically generated. Suppose if you want to insert a new line in a dataset or inside a PS or a PDS member, then you need to type I in the line number area and press enter. It will insert one new line. Suppose if you want to insert 10 lines, then you need to write I and after that you need to type 10 and then hit enter. It will insert 10 new blank lines. Inside that, you can write your data. Then the next is reset command. In reset command, why we use reset command? When you open a member, either it's a PS or it's a PDS member, one warning message comes on the top of the screen. To remove that warning message, we type RES. That's a command to remove the warning message. Then the next is columns. We type COLS in the command line and we hit enter. What's the purpose of this? While declaring a file, you give the record length. Suppose if you have given a 80 record length and if you want to see the column numbers, then all the column numbers, they will be presented on the top of that line. You type COLS, hit enter, you will get the column number starting from 1 to 80 as the record length was 80. So we'll cover all these concepts in hands-on.
We will perform basic operations on the PDS which we created in the last video. Go to utilities 3, DS list 4, enter the name of the PDS, so it's tutorial.point.asterisk. Test 1 is the PS and test 2 is the PDS. First of all, we'll add member in the test 2 PDS. Type E, go to end, after 2, put a bracket, enter the name of the member. I'm creating a test 1 member, close the bracket, press enter again. Type save. First of all, we'll save this member. Save command is used to save the member. Save. Enter. You will get a message, member test 1 saved here. For the first time, you need to type save. Once member is saved, from then edit the member and press F3. F3 will automatically save the member if opened in edit mode and exit. I'm opening the member again. This is the line area. It is of 8 characters and gets automatically populated when we enter data. This is the area where text is written. RES command. It's a reset command which is used to clear the warning message. Here you can see the warning message. Type RES in the command line and press enter. Now the warning message is cleared. Every time you open a new member in PDS or PS, you will receive this warning message. and you can get rid of this by res command. We will add some test data in the member. To insert a new line, type I here. Anywhere in these 8 line numbers. So type I. Enter. Enter some data. Press enter. Then next line will come automatically. If you press enter without writing anything in the second line, then the second line gets automatically deleted. I'm pressing enter again. So second line is gone. If you want to insert 5 lines, type I5. So I want line after this line. So I will write type I and then 5. So it will insert 5 lines. Press enter. So I will write some data here, test 1, in the second line I'm entering test 2, once I will press enter, the empty lines will be gone, so I'm pressing enter, so the empty lines are gone now. If you want an empty line, then enter a space in that line. Suppose I want an empty line after test 1. I will type I, enter. If I simply press enter again, it will go. So if I want this line, I will type I. I will type space, space bar. Once space has been inserted, press enter. Enter again. So here you can see, you got one more line. So it's a blank line. To display the column numbers, type COLS in the column line area and press enter. So suppose if I want columns here, COLS, I will press enter. The scale is being displayed here. This is the scale. So it starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this plus is 5, then this 1 is 10, then 15, 20, 25. It depends upon the record length. We have given 80 characters, so it will go till 80. If I want scale here before this line, I will type COLS again here. So I got one more scale. To clear the columns, like the scale which is being displayed here, type res command. This command is used to clear the columns, basically the scale. Press F3. I'm going out of this member. So our data is saved automatically. You do not need to write save again. Here you can see the message member test 1 saved. So to open a PDF, we have multiple modes. E command is used to open the PDF in edit mode. Whereas we can use M as well. Suppose if I want to open this PDF, we can use E. This is edit mode. And we can further edit these components. Or we can type M. M is member list, and we can open the PDFs with member list as well, and we can edit the members as well. To open a member in view mode, type V here, enter. In this mode, if you make any changes in the data, then the data changes will not be saved, and you will get this message at the bottom of the screen. Suppose I'm entering some data here, enter. So here you get the message, data changes cannot be saved in view session. So I will press F3. So it's asking for confirmation, press enter again. So my member is opened, my member was opened in view mode. So no changes have been made in this. To make the changes, open in edit mode like we did previously. The operations which we performed on the member of a PDS can be performed on the PS as well. So I will open PS, and the test one is PS. So again, you can see all the things. Like this is the line number, this is the area. So I'm going back F3. So in this video, we have covered some of the basic dataset commands like adding a new member, editing, insert, line numbers, columns, So in the next video, we'll cover some more commands like copy, paste, cancel, find, replace, and repeat.